Hello everyone, this is Jeff of TAOFLEDERMAUS. I think since Cars and Water did a red hot nickel ball with the antifreeze, it kind of made a lot of people want to see what antifreeze or engine coolant, whatever you want to call it, how it behaves in a sealed test tube and heated up with a torch. So let's see what happens. I actually thought this one was going to be a failure after about 5 minutes of being under the heat of this very hot propane torch. Nothing was happening. No color changes, a lot of boiling going on, and a lot of shaking. Now the boiling point of antifreeze is pretty high. It's 387 degrees Fahrenheit or 197 Celsius. Now antifreeze is added to a cooling system of a car or a motorcycle or whatever kind of internal combustion engine. It is there to enhance the properties of water. Now the properties of water are pretty amazing on their own, but it has limitations. It has a pretty high freezing point and a pretty low boiling point. So the antifreeze enhances the water by giving it a much lower freezing point. You don't want water to freeze in your engine because it'll split your block right open or cause freeze plugs to blow out. And of course you don't want the boiling point to be too low where, you know, your engine boils over and you overheat. The other thing about antifreeze is it has like corrosion inhibitors and other chemicals that prevent the, you know, rust and scale and all that stuff. And it's, you're supposed to change it out every 2 years or so in your engine. I think most people kind of neglect that. We got a lot of boiling going on. You would think the pressure is just going crazy in there as the fluid boils, and you know, we're at a really high temperature, so the pressure is starting to build up in this thing. But unlike a lot of the other experiments we've done, don't see much of a color change. We don't see it getting darker or foaming or, you know, really the level rising. So this is a very unique and different experiment. Alright, I don't want to put you to sleep here, so we're going to speed it up 4 times again. And just so you know, just so you're ready, when we go back to normal speed, it's about ready to blow. So stand by. So let's look at the high speed footage and see what happened on this thing. As you can see, the cap first blew off and then the silicone plug blew out. It was kind of like a delayed reaction, kind of weird. Now we'll look at it at 600 frames per second. You can see that I put a foam pad underneath it, hoping it'll protect the test tube, but that just didn't work out very well. But this was another interesting one, completely different results, and I hope you found it interesting. I always enjoy these. It's always a big surprise when I look at the footage afterwards. Thanks for watching.